Hello my friends of Qatari Labs, my name is Orwin Montoya. Welcome to this tutorial. This tutorial will be about the modeling of the groundwater flow on the fault zone. Okay, with Model Muse, Modpack 7 and Modflow 6 with the option DSB. Okay, so what are we going to model? Okay, we are not going to talk about the hydrogeology on the fault zone, but in the description of this video is this interesting paper that is called Fault Zone Hydrogeology. Okay, and there are a lot of discussion about when, how it works, which will be the main characteristic of the fault zone hydrogeology. But we are going to model this. We are going to model what we will be the distribution of the distribution of hydrogeological units on a normal fault, okay, where we have here the fault zone and the damage zone. Okay, the fault zone, we assume that is affected by how do you call it in English? By breccias, by, I don't know, brecciation. Okay. And so what does it mean that here the hydraulic conductivity is lower, and it's also coherent with this conceptualization by Charles et al, where you have higher permeability on the damaged zone, okay? You have higher permeability and very low permeability on the fracture zone, okay? And this conceptualization is the one that we are going to provide in an example model in Modflow 6 with Model Muse, okay? And then we are going to talk and to discuss about the, the water balance and the paths on the groundwater flow. We are going to do some particle tracking, okay, and the representation of the headache potentials. Okay, so this tutorial will be pretty interesting about to understand, to represent and understand how the faults are affecting a particular case of groundwater flow, it really depends on the conceptualization, the extension, the data that you have on a fault that you can, where you can really have an idea of how it works on a specific case. But I think that this tutorial will be much helpful for you to give an initial approach about this topic. Okay, great. So you will receive on the description of this video the paper, and as well you will receive some shape files, and then we are going to make our model from the shape files. Okay, so we open Model Muse, and then we create a new Modflow model. Next, actually one need is in Modflow 6. It will I will use the no grid option, but however this is 200 150 150. Okay, great, no grid option. Okay, and then what we do is we go to switch to this V. Okay, and here we import file, import shape file, and on shape file what we are going to import is the shape file of model extension 2. Okay, model extension 2, we have set value of enclosed cells, intersected cells, and that's all. Okay, great. Because if you go here to the objects, show or high objects, we have the model extension 2 here. Okay, we have model extension 2 here. We do double click, and then this will define a grid of 20, and I will change The color of this. No, nothing else. Okay, just type it. Okay, just type it. Okay. And with this one, we explode. We generate the grid. Okay, and this. Okay, haven't you seen? This is our grid. Okay. Great. So let's go to model. Let's go to package and programs. And then let's go to, we are going to work with MPF, Gauss Null Correction. We are going to work with the general head boundary. Yeah, just this example only has renal flow. And modpath. And some, we are going to run modpath later on. Okay, yes, okay, that's right. And then say file import. Okay, on layer groups actually will be confined. On time is on the steady state. Okay, and on program location for this tutorial you need Modflow 6 and Modpath 7. Okay, great. And then here on data, you go to edit datasets. On edit dataset, everything is active, everything is confined. If you type one, everything will be convertible. It's up to you. Let's type it one, okay? KX is equal to 1 × 10⁻⁶, yeah, because this is the rock, and KZ is equal to KX, okay? The initial head will be actually 198, okay, and that's it, nothing else. Okay, then go to import check file, and then we are going to have import renal flow, separate object, set value of intersected cells, one, and it will be datasets require layer definition model top. Yeah, and here on date, no features, let's go to general head, that it will be from mine, actually no name, okay, because it's better to do it one by one, because actually we have imported two. So here you have one in the left and one in the right. Okay, let's look at the one in the left. And this will be renal flow one. It will be a model top. You can change the color. And here on mode flow features, you go to general head from minus to zero. The boundary head here will be 180, and the conductance will be 1 × 10⁻³. Yep. Okay. And this one, we change also of color. Yeah. It will be from -0 to 1, and this will be 198, and this will be 1 e to the -3. Okay, great. So right now what we have is a general head, a flow that goes from 198 to 180 here. Okay, so, and actually, okay, on view vertical acceleration, we will put just 2. Okay, great. Vertical acceleration, just 1. Okay, and then we can simulate the renal flow and how much water actually comes from the renal flow in these conditions. So actually run, okay, I have to save my model, save, and then here you will receive a copy of that as well, of this model. And it will be called model one. For your case, you can call it. Okay, we have saved it, and then we have saved. And then, okay, the discrepancy seems okay. And then we see on the water balance that the general head brings 1 liter, because actually this is cubic meters per second, so I do the translation to liters per second, 1.4 liters per second, okay? And how is the distribution of heads? Let's look at this. Control grid, okay. And this is the distribution of heads. And this is, okay. Nothing, if this is the same as every other distribution. Okay, but let's insert the faults. Okay, let's insert the faults. So file, import, shape file, and then here on shape file, let's insert faults. Set value of intersected cells will be from model top, because actually the fault is fully penetrating. So actually from model top to lower aquifer bottom. It will be a single multipara option, because actually there are two faults, but they will work on a similar way. Okay, let's import it first. Okay, those are the faults. Here we have a complete crossing fault. And the other one, we have a smaller fault that crosses the bigger fault. Okay, I will double click here, because I change the color of the fault. Okay, and here on data sets, I do required hydrology. Okay, and KX, this will be 2 orders of magnitude less than the this will be the 2 orders of magnitude less than the fractured media. Why? Because of this conceptual modeling. Okay, here on this type of normal faults, we have brixation on the core, on the fault core. That's why the brixation makes a less permeable core, with less permeability and therefore less hydraulic conductivity, while the fracturing on the damaged zone provides more hydraulic conductivity. Okay, so that's something that first we are going to insert this. Okay, not this one, sorry, not this one. Actually, this will hide. This one is the faults that goes from the top to the bottom. We change the color of the fault, why not? Okay, and here on data sets, we go to model, to required hydrology, and here we set KX equals to 10 to the minus 8. Okay, this is 10 to the minus 8. Okay, so right now I will data, delete model results. I actually will save my project, okay? And then here, if I plot the hydraulic conductivity, we see that all cells that intersect the fault will be defined as a zones of low hydraulic conductivity. But if you see the paper, this conceptualization is much different of what you see on the paper. So what can we do? Okay, and then for that we are going to use the tools of ModFlow 6 and with the option DSB. Okay, what we are going to do is that we are going to look for this, double click, and then say, okay, in this part I want a quad 3 refinement. So actually I need some refinement of level 2. Okay, and why? Because with this, if I generate a grid, and then if I plot it, okay, Okay, if I plot it, actually you can see that there is a refinement close to the fault, okay, but there is no refinement out two cells outside the fault, okay, and where the fault is crossing the cells that are intersected by the fault, but in this case are cells with smaller cells. Those will be defined as as fault material, and we are talking about a cell discretization of 5 meters. Okay, if you put a quattro, look, if you put this, you do double click and then you put 3 on the quattro refinement and then you explode this. Actually, you can do much smaller faults. It really depends on the amount. Yeah, 3 meters, something like that. Okay. Let's see if we can work with these 3 meters. Okay. Okay, so we have here the core 1 to the minus 6, and then here we have the fault zone, but let's insert the altered zone. Okay, so in this case, file import check file, and the altered zone set value of enclosed cells, single multipart object 2, because actually it goes from model top to lower buffer bottom, okay, and this is the altered zone. This is the zone that on the conceptualization is actually was pretty stressed by the movement, by the shear force, and so on. That's why it is conceptualized that has more density of fault of discontinuities. Okay, so I select this, I change of color, model tab to lower aquifer bottom because it's fully penetrating. Yep, and here on hydrology, I say that this one is 1 10 to the minus 5, so it's actually one order of magnitude bigger than the fault zone. And then something happens because here is 1 10 to the minus 5 and here is 1 10 to the minus 6. But what happened with the hydraulic conductivity on the faults? Well, the hydraulic conductivity on the faults is actually below the altered zone. So actually, you define the fault, you define the hydraulic conductivity on the fault, and then you have defined the altered hydraulic conductivity for everything. So this is a problem of hierarchy. Not this is not very difficult to solve. Just you have just to select the altered zone and then you say to back, not back one. Okay, and that's it. I only needed to back one. Okay, and here we have 10 to the minus, look what appears here, 10 to the minus 6, 10 to the minus 5, and 10 to the minus 8, and this is a representation, numerical representation of this one. Lower hydraulic conductivities, higher hydraulic conductivities, very low hydraulic conductivities on the fault zone. Okay? Data, delete more results, and then I run my model. Okay, so here I have some discrepancy. Okay, so and then on the water balance, here we have that. Okay, the general, I mean, 1.4 was the former de forma de hydraulic conductivity, and right now the original flow is actually 1.4, so there is no much difference on how much water enters the fault zone, the model. Okay, let's see if we have a better, let's see if we have an impact on the flow patterns. Okay, so from here with this one, we import the results model VH1 como control grid. Okay, here I can show exterior, and this is how the hydraulic conductivities are, how this is how the core, the fault core and the damage zone are changing the patterns of the change the patterns of the groundwater flow on the model. Okay, but this is the distribution of hydraulic conductivities. We can also provide particle tracking in order to see, to show the distribution of the direction of water. Okay, how do that? How to do that? We go to model, package and programs, and here on solve, on post processor mod path, is on level 7. We are going to work about path lines, and this will be stop at termination, points. Okay, so path lines 7. Okay, and here is stop at termination points. Okay, with that we go to this one, that is the hydraulic conductivity on the eastern part of the model. Okay, so here we have, and then if we go to mod flow feature, we can see also the mod path. Okay, we will have one, well, we can do two per 2%. Okay, and then just type okay, and then with this we export mod path, because actually to run mod path you don't need to run modflow again. So it's for modpath input files. Okay, there is a mass balance here, but we are not going to show it. What we are going to show you are the path lines here on the path, on the model path lines. We can open the model one path. Yeah, that is also model. Okay, and then we go from light to dark. Okay, and then we put apply, but we do not limit to the extent. Okay, blue to gray. Okay, great. So what do we have here? Okay, here with the path, with the particle tracking, there is a better understanding of what is going on with the model. Okay, we see, for example, that this part of the fault is actually has a capture zone. So actually water is being captured by the high hydraulic conductivity here, and is being conducted, okay, to this part, and is it goes out here in this part. Okay, and for example, water that comes here actually goes into the fracture, crosses the fault, and then it still go north, or like northwest, and then it takes out of the altered zone and became renal flow. Okay, so here we see, for example, this is the capture zone of the altered zone of the altered rock here. For example, in this part, water that reaches the fall actually are being transported in the on the damage zone to extension. Okay, that can actually cross the vexation, or the low, the fault core or the low hydraulic conductivity material. Okay, and this also discharge here. Okay, so we see some particular things of the fault. For example, this is a is a this is a sink. Okay, that water, that there is a lot of water that goes in between the altered zone, and then after being in the altered zone, they cross the fault. Okay, they cross the fault in order to discharge to zones where with less hydraulic conductivity. Okay, and here in this part as well, the fault can discharge water to the system. Okay, and as you have seen, this is the distribution, and then we see that a lot is going in the first layer, and then some part of the flow also goes in the coming layers. Okay, so this is the tutorial, and I hope that it will be interesting for you to understand how fault zone hydrogeology works. Okay, and this is for the case of normal faults. There will be another cases for other types of solvers. No, for other type of solve of faults, because there are some tensional faults, some compression faults, and so on. So this is only for this case, the one that appears here on the paper of fault zone hydrogeology. Okay. My name is Saul Montoya. We are from Hatari Labs. Hatari Labs is a blog dedicated to the promotion of open source software in water resources, especially in groundwater modeling. We hope that you like our videos, our tutorials, and we hope to see you in coming tutorials as well. See you. Bye bye. Bye.